Hello, this is Amethyst Lunatari, the RPG chick. Welcome to Let's Play Fallout 2, Blind. Finally getting to this one, just finished Fallout 1. For anyone watching currently, I apologize, I wanted to get this episode up on the same day as the intro, but that took me forever and to do, not only because, well, the time doing stuff. I have a custom prelude, sort of. It's mostly reading the text of the Vault Dweller, the memoirs of the Vault Dweller from Fallout 1, only I've rearranged the text and added in some of my own stuff to more accurately reflect my playthrough, so, and I changed the music for the intro to a female singing, A Kiss to Dream On. So, yeah, from the movie, the 1951 film, The Strip. It's called The Strip. So, and actually, what's his name is in it, Louis Armstrong, what's his name. So, yeah, Philip fits the, it fits the playthrough, as I have playing once again a female vault dweller, wanderer, what have you, protagonist. So that fits. A couple things. Plus she says at the end, well, why can't I do it? Yes, exactly. Why can't she do it? So she is doing it in a way, sort of, kind of metaphorically. Playing blind, of course, so of no spoilers, please. I have not seen info. Like. I'm gonna mute that out. It's gonna start like that, isn't it? So. The only thing I know is that we're playing a descendant of the original Vault Dweller. So in my playthrough is Allison King. So this one's going to be Andrea King. And I think it's the original Vault Dweller's granddaughter, or grandchild, but in this case, your granddaughter. So, I know that. I know that this game is substantially longer than the first one, and there was more wacky stuff, more crazy humor. I heard that the game is kind of all over the place due to it switched development teams once or twice. Tim Kaine left before the game was finished, and then Chris Avalon took over. So, there's a lot of people, like entire teams, coming and going. So. Oh, that's what happened, see? Okay, so it brings you here. I had to restart, obviously, the game and the recording. I might not be able to continue with Bandicam, but I had problems with the first game with Shadowplay. I heard fraps, even if it doesn't matter how fast your computer is, it will slow down like crap. And that's really all I have as far as recording stuff. I don't really feel like buying anything else. I don't feel like learning OBS. Yeah, we'll see. We'll see what we can do. But anyway, yeah, so blind playthrough, please no spoilers. I just know a few things, you know. I just know that the game is crazy. A lot of people say it's their favorite Fallout, or at least favorite Fallout of the classic ones, so we'll see if it'll be mine as well. Now, I read all the things, except for repeat things, and of course, things that are repeated from the first Fallout, I'm going to read them again, because some people might just be watching this, who knows, and altered text, who knows, so if you don't like someone who reads all the things, you know, everything that isn't voiced, you know, and has text, and, this might not be the playthrough for you. I am playing with the Fallout 2 Restoration Project, which fixes bugs and adds cut content from the game. Quite a bit of cut content, from what I understand. So, playing version 2.3.3 of that, which is the latest version at this time. I might crash again. Okay, I want to show you guys the options. Screen settings. Okay. Now, I'm playing this the same as the last time. You guys know, the scaling by 2 There's no... Yeah. Even with 1920 by 1080, which is my monitor resolution, even with the scaling times 2, the characters and things are like way... You know, everything's tiny and stretched out. So it helps if you're trying to like get an overall view of the land and the area. So, but not so much if you want to see things, if you want to see little animations and you know, I guess text will get smaller too, so I really don't like that, so I don't want to stretch it out to 1080. This game did come out in 1998. So we are going to play the same way as last, for Fallout 1, the same way as last time. 1280 by 960, but I'm going to be recording it that way, and going with the encoding or the processing, making it 1280 by 720 because I don't think YouTube doesn't have a format for 960, and there is no 960p. It's 720p, 1080p, and we have like 480p, and I think there's still 360. I'm not even sure. 360p, 240p. So no, I'm gonna make it 720. The reason I'm doing it on this and not any longer, which makes everything, you know, more details, is because YouTube has this compression ratio that anything 720p or over gets a higher compression quality. So the quality of the video is improved overall just because I'm uploading it in 720p and not 480. So that's my main reason there. So you want good quality with your videos. So 32-bit refresh rate, I've left that as it. I don't think you have to mess with this generally. Window mode, yeah, it's the same stuff. Pathfinding range. Increase the number of search nodes to extend the pathfinding distance. Might not have to mess with that, but I'll keep it in mind. Fit the screen for that. This was set like this. I like this one. This is the way it was in the first. That's the way I had it in the first game. Every time the piano comes up, I don't know. I don't want to get hit by content ID match. So that's the reason I took out the standard intro song, the Louis Armstrong song. Okay, so options again. Game preferences. Now a normal, maximum blood, target highlight, targeting only, combat looks. I don't even know what that is. Combat looks? So I might look into that and see what that is, see if I want to keep it on. Combat messages, verbose, taunts on, just in case it bothers people. People get, you know, salty. Language filter off. Running always, subtitles on. This I changed, that was off. I think running was normal, I think I changed that. Item highlight, yes, please, on, the little tiny things. Hard to find on screen, and combat speed, I put this up to here. It helps a little. Not so long animations waiting for people to take an action, kind of thing. Text delay is slow. I wish they'd have no delay. Text delay off and just have you know, press down, you know, the down arrow to, but I mean, even with the speech for the first game, we'll see how it is in this one, but even with the speech, the characters, the text would advance, but the character's still saying this something like three lines before on you know, and you have to change it back, and I don't know why they did that. I think this should be fine. I think I had the other one on normal. I can hear myself, alright, so. Brightness level, I made a little brighter. And that's it. So, done, and nope. New game, I might crash again. Yep. Okay. It's crashing because I have Bandicam running, from what I've heard. So at least that's what I think it is. What I might be doing is what I heard it has to do with animations, because I installed the restoration mods. I heard someone was saying that they heard that the animations, the custom animations, or added animations make it crash. But I'm loading a new thing. There's no animation here, so I'm not sure. So either I might get rid of those animations or try to find a new recording program other than being... I might try Fraps. I don't know. I don't want to run this full screen, really. And then I won't be able to play it. I don't know how playing it in this resolution, 1280 by 960, will work. I don't know. So, I might have some growing pains. I might just deal with it. Maybe it only shows up now and then. If it's constant, you know, I'm going to do something. And these characters are interesting, of course. I'm not going to choose any of them. Norg, though. Norg's exceptional physique has made him one of the best hunters in the tribe. Norg's first and usually only impulse is to crush anything that he can figure out. Norg has become quite adept at crushing and slicing and dicing. Norg would like to prove his worthiness to lead the tribe, and he'll let nothing stand in his way. Sounds pretty cool. Sounds like a cool NPC I want to run into. Mingan's story, who's really good at sneak lockpicking and stealing. Mingan. Did I say Ningan? Mingan's whisper, soft tread, and acquisitive fingers have always aided his natural curiosity. Several years ago, the tribe decided that Mingan's talents would be best used on someone else. Since then, Mingan has been the tribe's most accomplished scout. However, the tents of nearby tribes provide little challenge these days. It's time to scout further afield. I wonder if there's anything more to these characters, like if... Oh, she's got sex appeal? Yeah, I'd say so. I wonder if there's, like, any, like, custom reactions to these characters. It'd be interesting, but... So she's... Look at that! It's Lily. Speech and barter. Speech and barter. My name is not Lily's playthrough. I watched after finishing Fallout 1. But yeah, speech and barter. He was always putting skill in that. Chitsa. Anyway, Chitsa has always been able to convince others to do things her way. Her winning personality and stunning good looks have often caused others to underestimate the tribe's best trader. In the course of her frequent journeys, Chitsa has learned to deal with the perils of traveling the wastes. Now the tribe needs help, and new paths beckon to Chitsa. So these are characters, but I'm going to create a character. And I have written down somewhere... Stats? Where did I write this? I'm so disorganized, guys. I'm sorry. I think about it. So... Yeah. Character creation. What I'm going to do is I'm going to do the same. I don't know, maybe you guys will like it, maybe it's not. I feel it's like continuing a tradition. So, I'm going to be doing everything, picking the same. And this is Andrea King, obviously, related. Age 25, we'll keep the same. This? You are the generic default female character. You come from a long line of generic default female characters. I don't know why you can't change the race there. Style. Unlike most of your fellow tribeswomen, who wear their long hair in a ponytail, your black hair is square cut and shoulder length. So what if they snicker and call you Buckethead behind your back? Oh, okay, so we can change... You know what? I feel like there would be arrows here to change race, no? I'm actually clicking, and just in case it's invisible or something. So this, I naturally thought this was stuck, you know, as well. Your silken honey blonde tresses have always made you stand out among your tribe. The boys ogle, the girls scowl, and you wouldn't have it any other way. I don't think this affects the game, though. Red hair. Some say your crimson hair indicates that you lack a soul. But when you look this good, who needs one? Going for red hair? Yeah, red hair. Hell to the yeah with that. I usually go for red hair when I'm... Any, like, modern RPG where you get to, you know... mess with your appearance and stuff. So... before I change any of this stuff, I am taking... Bloody Mess again. As in the same game, the first game. And Gifted again. Now this means... look at that. All your stats go up by one. They're all five. Now they're all six. So strength... I'm keeping it six. This is all the same. Perception is seven. Very good. Good for that. That endurance, right? Yeah. Charisma is eight. Intelligence. Intelligence was nine. Oh, wait. Oh, that's right, because I took away from luck. I put luck down to four. So intelligence is nine. Excellent. And agility, seven. Very good. So six, seven, six, eight, nine, seven, four. These were the same stats as Allison King in the beginning of Fallout 1. And the same traits. So, but as far as the skills, I'm going to mix it up a little bit. Well, I'm going for small guns again. As a tag skill. I'm also taking throwing. As the other tag skill. And... that leaves first aid. I think in the first game I had small guns, first aid, and doctor. So unfortunately I don't have doctor this time. So cool. Done with that. I'm gonna save, because once I go done, you can still print. You can print to a file now, huh? I'm not saving the game at this point. I'm saving the character, aren't I? Oh, I can't put any more than that. Okay. Andrea. Andrea.gcd. Game character. Something. Well, I didn't really do much. I thought I could save the game from there, though. Okay, let's go done and hope we don't crash.
Come in, Chosen One. There are things you must know. The village is dying. The signs are everywhere. Withering crops.
Yeah.
Dying Brahmin. Sick children. There is hope, however, a slim hope, that few know of. The old discs speak of an item called the Garden of Eden Creation Kit.
Mm-hmm.
It is said it can bring life to the wasteland.
A scene in the intro. It's pretty cool looking.
This will be your quest, if you prove yourself worthy. For that proof, you must first journey to the Temple of Trials. If you survive, come back to me. We will talk more.
If I survive.
Our life is in your hands, Chosen One. Prove yourself. Find the Gek. Be our salvation.
Nice. Okay, I'm going to immediately save, because I'll be saving past all these crashes. Okay, so let's check out us. We have 33 hit points. I have a spear, a razor tip polearm. The shaft is wooden and the tip is worked steel.
Okay.
That's all we have. I'm looking forward to seeing this inventory fill up with crap. Sounds very tribal here. Here's our character. I had to do everything over again. I couldn't find a place to load that character that I made, so I don't know. So anyway, down there. Nothing out of the ordinary. Who's that? Clint, a fellow tribesman. You see a young man with bulging muscles and a very confident air about him. So I'm going to work out these kinks, guys, somehow. Good day to you, Andrea King. You have not completed the trial of the Elder and may not pass. I have some questions for you. Forgive me, but I have no answers to your questions. Take the trial set before you by the Elder and prove yourself worthy to lead our people. Very well. But wait. Just out of curiosity. Forgive me, Andrea King, but I cannot allow you to pass. If you wish to return to the village, you may do so only by passing the trial set before you. Okay. So it's either death or trial. Got it. She's a redhead. She's fiery. I could kick your ass and just walk out of here. Two people working together can move the obelisk that blocks the path. Alone, you would fail. I have no intention of helping you until you pass the trial of the Elder. Oh, meaning that we both have to... Okay. I get the picture. Is this the obelisk? A pole with human skulls attached. Wait. What'd I do? Try to pick it up? A very large pile of rocks. They look dangerous just sitting there. Here's the zone. A cave-in. So just as always, I can look at stuff even though I'm nowhere near it. A large amount of rock. Far more than could ever be moved easily. Cacti, nothing important. I heard a crazy bird. A dead tree. Nothing grows well here. Yo. Fire pit. Nothing out of the ordinary, just your average fire pit. Bones. You think these might be horned kangaroo bones, but you cannot be sure. You're too weathered to make a final determination. Is there anything nearby? That's right. Okay, walk through this way, but there's nothing there. I can't leave the area. More horn kangaroo bone. Okay. Temple. I wish we had a description of the temple. Hmm. Okay. I have always run on, so when I press down shift, like I did in the first game, I had to remember not to do that. When I press down shift, now I walk, so... You're in a dark, musty temple. The shadows seem to play tricks with your eyes, and you can hear the faint sound of movement. I only have a spear, unfortunately, and no healing items. That is... What is that? A giant ant? I can try to talk to it. Unhurt, of course. A stone bench. Nothing out of the ordinary. What about these torches? Can I look at these? Yeah. I suppose I can take... No, I can't take it. A lit torch and a wall sconce. Okay, I guess I have to kill this ant. with my spear. Let's wait for it to attack. You never know, it might not attack. It might be just some ant. Nope, it's gonna attack me. Well, should I have good reach with this? Not good enough, though. How close do I have to get? This spear is long. You should not have to get up right up to it. Oh, I can't see it. 22%? Oh wait, I'm on... no. I don't want to do that. I don't want to throw it either. That's mine. Thrust. Still. And I missed. It's not attacking though. Hoping this doesn't crash here. I'm gonna save over in a new slot because, well, I want to get back to the preferences and I don't want anything to crash on me, so I'm gonna turn running to normal because I'm just in the habit of pressing shift to run, so it'll be easier that way. Hit for 10 hit points and was killed. Okay, that one doesn't care yet. I got 25 XP for that. Okay, I guess it doesn't have anything. I mean, in the first you would have, you know, a grab icon, but there would just be nothing there. Now there's just nothing. Nothing out of the ordinary. Okay, wooden bench. Well, I'm just gonna walk nonchalantly back up. A door with an intricate lock. Burning braziers. And yeah, they're braziers, not braziers. Full of burning coals. Braziers or something else. Okay, it's coming. Pretty sure I have to get right up to it, even though I have this pole. Missed. And I'm running away as much as I can. And I guess it misses a turn. Okay, now it's gonna go. It missed. I have a very low percent to hit. So the reason I ran away, just for you guys to know, if you're not familiar, it didn't get to attack me this round because it had to run back up to me. So let them come to you is the motto, and keep some distance. Unless you're dealing with a ranged opponent. In which case, either find cover or get up to them and kill them. That's my way. See, he's not been able to attack me at all. We could probably keep going like this forever. Hope not. You guys would be bored. We are going to have to keep going like this forever because he's not hitting me. I keep missing. Gotcha. Destroyed enemies without a scratch. So yeah, there is nothing Okay. I feel like I'm in Raiders of the Lost Ark. Closed off little room here. I think I'll go here first. Or try to. I don't know if I'm going to encounter anything. A wall, nothing out of the ordinary. I'm trying to look at these, like, they look like drainage pipes or something. They got little benches for you, a lot of benches for you to sit down and relax. A floor depression. Nothing out of the ordinary. I'm not sure if you should believe that there's nothing out of the ordinary. Oh, there's a... what is that? A scorpion. Not a rad scorpion, I notice. A scorpion. Okay, let's do the scorpion dance. -33%, a little better chance. Fortunately, I did miss. I would stay here, but I don't know if these things... Nope, see? It doesn't attack. That might have to do with my sequence. Sequence is 14. How soon in a combat turn your character can react? Of course. So, I guess one round went... It ran up, I went, but now this round I get to go first. I think that's how it's working. Yeah, this is gonna be a little boring to watch. Just doing a dance. Damn it. It's a good thing it doesn't affect my endurance, swinging so much. Now, I expect these will be a little tougher than the ants. Although I did kill it in one hit. Well, that was 11 points, so that was pretty good. See, now we have the grab icon. Now we got a small scorpion tail. Oh, I got a take all button. That's cool. Take all button. A small improvement. I got 60 points for that. Because I got no damage. The severed tail of a small rad scorpion. Interesting, because they're not calling them rad scorpions here. It's just a type of rad scorpion that's smaller. Where was this one? Oh, here he is. Now I'm going to make a bet that I get to attack twice. And I'm going to end my turn. Good. And missed. Running. Hoping one shot again for these guys. For this guy. Running around a depression. Yeesh. Give me a gun or something. That's a thing, though. It's because I'm using melee weapons, and I'm It's not even attack skill. I have only 36% in that skill. So that's why I suck at this. Give me a gun. That's all I'm saying. Finally, three hit points though. It's still. Just curious if it's almost dead. Just regular wounded, okay. Sorry guys, this probably isn't very interesting to watch. Oh, that was probably. Yeah, it still didn't attack. I thought I messed that one up. Three hit points again! Still standing. Severely wounded. Well, we know the other one was at most 11 hit points. Of course, they may vary. I got it. It didn't make as impressive a sound that time. I just wanted to use the take all. Couldn't it? It stacks it. Okay, good. Okay. You cannot get there. Yeah, I literally can't walk there. I wonder what's the deal with the depression, though. Hmm. Interesting. So we're in this little room off to the side, and yeah, that's it for episode. Well, technically two. But first gameplay episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode, and always seek adventure.